Well, BP officials continue to refuse to appear on our program, which is certainly their right. They can hide from appearing before Congress. Today, the chairman and president of BP America, Lamar McKay, testified before the House Energy and Environment Subcommittee. McKay, along with the executives from four other oil companies, were blasted by lawmakers, and McKay got the worst of it. Listen to what Congressman Cliff Stearns of Florida and Joseph Cao of Louisiana said to him.
It's really outrageous that you sit here and tell us that you're going to punt to the unified command when we've had 11 people killed, we've had a huge environmental damage, and you're still sitting here as a CEO of BP. Frankly, I would call for your resignation. I'm calling for it for today. I'm not asking for an apology. I'm asking you to resign.
Mr. Stern asked Mr. McKay to resign. Well, in the Asian culture, we do things differently. You know, during the samurai days, we just give you a knife and ask you to commit harakiri.
Pretty surprising stuff, perhaps an example of the anger out there. McKay was joined on Capitol Hill today by the executives from four other oil companies. This was really fascinating. As we told you at the top, three of the companies said they were getting information from an expert, a scientist, who's actually dead. Four of the companies have plans to protect walruses in the Gulf from a spill, walruses not having been here for 3 million years. And then there's this. This is what BP calls its quick guide to a regional oil spill response plan. Now, there's a section on safety and a section on spill assessment. Now, take a look at this sheet, all right? That's what it looks like. Now, check out this one. This is ExxonMobil's quick guide to an oil spill plan in the Gulf. Does it look familiar? It should, because it is virtually identical to the sheet from BP. Now, let me show you Chevron's solution. This is their quick guide to a regional spill. And wouldn't you know it, except for some different fonting and maybe a change in a word or two, identical to the versions from BP and ExxonMobil. Finally, ConocoPhillips, with a carbon copy of the other guides. These are companies that are making billions of dollars each. Representative Ed Markey of Massachusetts is the chairman of the subcommittee. He called McKay and the other executives to the Capitol today, and he joined me earlier. Congressman, some of the stuff that you revealed today on Capitol Hill was just stunning. I mean, we've seen that BP's response plan, you know, listed a dead scientist as a contact and talked about walruses in the Gulf when there was a spill, when obviously there haven't been walruses there for some 3 million years. But to learn that other companies out there have pretty much the exact same plan with the exact same language and quoting, you know, referencing the exact same scientists and even talking about saving walruses was incredible to me.
Well, it's pretty obvious that none of the companies have actually invested in 21st century technologies that make it possible to either shut down the leak or to respond to the damage which is being done out in the ocean and to the livelihoods of people. The one new technology that they invested in was apparently a Xerox machine, because they each had, for all intents and purposes, the same plan with the same mistakes in it. Walruses that they could respond to in the Gulf of Mexico. Dead people with their phone numbers who haven't been around since 2005. So I think it's just an indication of how completely disinterested that each of the companies were in making the investment in a capacity to respond if an accident occurred. And we see the results every single day.
Well, also a sign of just how lax the government oversight was. I mean, basically rubber stamping these you know, so-called safety plans or spill response plans. I mean, do you literally think that they just, somebody made up this plan and then they just Xeroxed it? Because you're saying it's like 90% the same wording.
Either they Xeroxed it or the same company sold the same plan to all of the oil companies, and that was their spill response.
And in BP's response plan, they said they could handle 250,000 barrels of oil a day. These other plans are a little bit more cautious. They say 200,000 barrels. But my point is, if they have the technology to handle 200,000 barrels, they should speak up, because folks at BP and a lot of folks here would love to hear this technology. Chances are their numbers are as made up as BP's 250,000 barrel a day figure.
Well, we learned today, and they all admitted it, that none of them have the capacity to respond to a worst case scenario. And that can be 250,000, 200,000, 100,000, 50,000, 30,000. They admitted that none of them have the capacity. So this whole basic plan that was put together by the oil industry was go to the MMS, get them to approve ultra deep technology, and just coast by, not actually putting in place the ultra safe drilling technologies or the ultra fast response capacity that they would need if something went wrong. And they just cut corners, they shortchange safety, and the people in the Gulf are the victims.
When you hear today that now the government flow rate team says it's upwards, it could be 60,000 barrels, that's their new high estimate. I mean, do you believe these numbers at this point? I mean, it seems like every week there's a new number, and BP for the longest time has been clinging to the lowest possible numbers they can get. And in fact, when independent scientists weeks ago said, well, it could be 70,000, they attacked that guy. They said it's inaccurate. They said it's alarmist.
You know, right from the beginning, I have not believed BP. I have not believed their numbers. It's why I forced them to put up the spill cam so that experts could analyze this flow rate. I think that the number could even go higher. I think that we are in a worst-case scenario. I think that BP was trying to limit their liability because they pay a fine per barrel of oil that's out there. They were lying or grossly incompetent. And I think that the livability of the Gulf is, as a result, been victimized by BP. But these numbers, these are the numbers that we should have known in the very beginning. If we had known it was 60,000 barrels per day, it would have changed the number of skimmers, the amount of boom, the amount of protection for the health of the workers, the amount of chemicals that went into the ocean, the amount of compensation that would be needed for the people on shore. All of it would have been different, and BP kept it from the government and from the people.
Congressman Markey, I appreciate your time. Thank you.
Thank you. Thanks for having me on.
Still ahead, we'll have reactions to the president's primetime speech from the Oval Office. Is it really possible they're going to have 90% of the oil cleaned up in a matter of weeks or contained? That's what the president said tonight. Billy Nungesser, David Gergen, Garland Robinette are back with us. And later, saving the most vulnerable victims of this catastrophe, baby birds devastated by the spill, now allegedly being harmed by BP workers sent to clean up the oil mess in the marsh. Details on that ahead.